Hey everybody, so today we're gonna talk about periods. Isn't that fun? I have recently, I don't know, felt this sense of relief as far as, you know, just feeling like I can talk about anything and everything on this channel because you guys are like family and let's just talk about stuff, right? Why not? And I, over the past few months and within the last year, have discovered the amazing concept of period cups. Menstrual cups. I wanted to kind of talk about the ones that I've used, which one I like, which ones I dislike, and the ones I would generally just like recommend for you guys. But of course, everyone is different, internally, externally. We are all different in some way, and our needs are different. Our flows are different. Everything's different. So what works for me will not automatically work for you guys. And also, I wanted to mention my best friend. She's pretty awesome. Her name is Kelly. She has a channel on YouTube called It's Just Kelly, and she does a monthly period review. She tries out so many different types of period products that you wouldn't even know existed. She's done everything from many, many, many different types of menstrual cups to sea sponges, to reusable pads, to reusable tampons, and she shows you how each work for her as far as like real blood is being shown and stuff like that. So if you're very, very interested in stuff like that, I will link off her channel down below. I am not showing you guys any blood today because I'm not on my period, so I have nothing to show you guys. Plus, I think that's more her forte, while foundations and, you know, stuff like that, I'll stick to what I'm good at. Okay? So she has tried different cups than I have tried, but of course we have different internal parts and we FaceTime each other and talk about, you know, our needs and stuff and how the cups work for us. I get some, you know, sneak peeks on results sometimes, you know. I'm very, very excited about this video. While prepping to make this video, I was actually approached by the number one rated app from researchers and doctors for period-related, menstrual-related things, and it's called Clue. Yes, like the board game, C-L-U-E. And I'm going to show you guys quickly how that app works. It's pretty awesome before I get into my cup rant. This is what it looks like. It basically is a very, very simple interface, which I appreciate because I like a simple interface on my apps. And this says enter today's data, and then you pick which apply to you. I've also already filled out like my information as far as how long my cycles are, how long my periods are, and you know, any other symptoms and such, which I'll get into after I fill this out. I am not bleeding, so I get to fill in my emotions. So I'm kind of PMS-y today, so we're gonna hit the PMS button. And then sleep wise, I got 6 to 9 hours, which is awesome. They have a birth control section as far as it goes, and if you're on the pill, this app will be a lifesaver for you because it will inform you what to do if you miss a pill. Also, it will remind you to take your pill. I am not on the pill, so my profile says that I'm on my IUD, and this is the IUD page, so it basically says, has the threads been checked? Has it been inserted or removed? And I'm gonna fill out the fact that everything is good to go. Also, add other options as far as cravings or digestion, etc., etc. So it's a really, really awesome app. I am due for my period in a few days. It kind of sucks, honestly, because it has like that little reminder. But I mean, it's good to know. You can plan your vacations, stuff like that, around you knowing. And for someone like me who has a irregular cycle, I've always had like over a 28-day cycle. I've always had like a 33 to 36-day cycle. Obviously, that can be counterproductive. This app is awesome for that. So if you guys are interested in seeing how Clue can help you as far as maybe conceiving goes or not conceiving goes, it will help you know your days you're fertile, infertile, etc., etc. Remind you of your birth control option just in case you don't want no kids. I don't blame you, you don't want no kids. And you know, just a nice way to track what's going on with your body. And it's a really, really cute, simple interface. I can totally appreciate that. Otherwise, I don't like difficult apps, and this app's not difficult to use at all. So if you guys are interested, the app is free, and I will leave the link at the top of the info box. If this is an uncomfortable video for you at all, you might want to stop watching now. So I'm going to be talking about two brands as far as menstrual cups go. So prior to using menstrual cups, I was an Advid Playtex Sport tampon user. Advid. For many, many years now. I got my period at 11. I'm 24 now. I started with pads in high school. I switched to tampons because honestly, I'm just a tampon girl at heart, I think. Aside from now, there are cups. There weren't cups back then, at least widely available. So you can find like Diva Cup. I think that's the most widely available brand at Target. I have tried Diva Cup before and I had a very, very traumatizing time with the cup. Very traumatizing. Like I stayed away from cups for another like 3 years because there was some pain involved, user error. And cups are so confusing. I don't blame anyone for not wanting to use them because there's sizes, there's types, there's shapes, there's so many brands, it's overwhelming. And I wish I could help everyone out there who's confused right now understand it all, but you're gonna have to just read into the brand or site that you're interested in. They have sizing guides and those are just guidelines. Not everything is gonna be exactly right for you. As far as Diva Cup, there's two sizes and there's like recommendations, and I don't like the recommendation of like if you've given birth, if you haven't given birth, because I've had two kids, but certain sizes don't always apply to everyone because we have different internal needs, like I said. It's kind of more based on how strong your walls are. Obviously, if you had a kid, you're not supposed to have as strong of a wall as someone who just got their period, obviously. And just because you are a teenager or you just don't like tampons doesn't mean a cup won't work for you and doesn't mean it will work for you otherwise. But certain brands have different sizes. I love options. I'm a girl who likes to eat a little bit from every section of the menu, so of course I love options. So there are like teen sizes, low cervix sizes, regular sizes, heavy flow type of options, if that makes sense. So for me, your girl has a low, I feel like a how low can you go kind of moment, low cervix. Kind of sucks. Honestly, it's kind of sucks. And that I know because I've had two kids and I've known for a while, because doctors will tell you. And I also have like a uterus that like leans back and stuff like that. I don't know, I forgot the medical term. But anyway, now we know each other on a deeper level, kind of, I guess. So for me, I have to get brands that have a low cervix option. If you do not know what a low cervix, if you do not know what a low cervix means, it basically means like, you know, the end of when you put your hand there and come on. We're being grown-ups here. You put your hand there, there's like an end point, that is your cervix, where, you know, you hit something. Mine's low. Mine's like about this distance from the outside world. And your cervix moves depending on what activities, wink, wink, you're doing. Your cervix, you know, moves, and it also moves during your menstrual cycle. On heavier days, it's way farther back. On light days or non-bleeding days, it's way lower. But mine naturally sits lower than the average person, thus needing the low cervix cups. So if we're common low cervix sisters, pound it. Just because I'm gonna be showing you guys low cervix cups, which are all clean by the way, doesn't mean it only works for those type of girls. So your cups will come in bags most likely. I'm gonna show you guys Mi Luna cups and the FemiCycle cup. So I have a bunch of Mi Luna cups, so I have a bunch of these bags, and they come with like a little cleaning brush and like one disposable wipe, and there's cleaning instructions and stuff like that. It's really, really simple. It's not hard at all. There's sanitizing instructions, etc., etc. So the appeal of menstrual cups are that they last very long and they are not toxic. You're not putting chemicals into your body, and usually when you lean more towards natural period methods like cups or, you know, organic things, your body reacts differently, and sometimes your periods get lighter. My best friend Kelly said her period got way lighter once she started using cups. Like, it's almost gone. I'm so jealous. But I can agree that my period has been easier to manage and just generally easier time because I have severe PMS, mood-wise, cramp-wise. I'm the only one in my family who gets severe, like I'm in labor cramps. I've been in labor as well, so I can compare it. My best friend also has endometriosis. She low-key thinks I do. I might, who knows. But, girls, it's hard being girls. I know it is. So let's talk about the Mi Luna cups. So I have three different types. I went into the, I bought so many that I had to figure out which one I like. So the first type is this clear one, and the Diva cups are way bigger. Cups come in all shapes and sizes, like I said. These are the low cervix ones. That's why they're so small, because you do not want your cup to smash into your cervix. You want it to sit under your cervix, because if, let's say your cervix sits really low, this is all the space you got, but your cervix is all the way back there, you might need a bigger cup. Does that make sense? So anywho, this is for my light days. I will put the details and the name and all that on the sidebar, because I can't recall everything. And the Mi Luna cups retail for $25 each. Cups can retail from around like $16 to $60 depending on what you get. And you might spend a lot of money trying to find the one that works for you, or you might get it on your first shot. If you're lucky, you will. But then you never have to buy tampons again, guys. Or you never have to buy pads again unless you want to keep some around. I keep some around for emergency days or if I have company over and I have liners and stuff like that. And I have like Thanks period panty underwears and stuff like that, which are cute. They also have different ends. You see this one has like a ring and this one has a ball end. I have two ball ends and one ring because I don't like the stem. The stem is the long skinny thing that most people cut off. Don't care for that, but you do need something usually to help you like grab and yank it out. So I'm not gonna go into like a DIY how to use it type of thing, because the instructions will tell you how to properly fold them and scoot it up. This is all it is. It's like basically the size of a tampon, just burp, and it like sits in there. And then there's a proper way to break the seal and all that jazz. So my favorite from the Mi Luna line is this. For my light spotting days, I use this instead of a liner, and you can use it for like 12 hours straight and then just pour everything out into your toilet or your sink, wash it properly, and you're good to go. So I was using this Mi Luna, which is the classic low cervix, and I will say I like the ball handle better because then the ring isn't kind of like sticking out oddly and like poking me or whatever. But this is a denser cup. They have different densities. This is the classic. This is like the light. As you can see, they squish a little differently. This one's like really squishy while this one's like denser. And then the sport is like, oh, it does not move very well. It's very, very dense. And that one is better for those who have a tighter wall or play sports, and they describe everything on their website as far as that goes. This one was kind of uncomfortable to me, and I could feel I had a cup in, so I was like, not for me. When you have the proper sizing and proper cup density and all that good stuff, you won't really feel it, and that's great. I have one of my other friends just starting to use cups, and she loves it, because you don't have to worry about like, oh my god, is my tampon leaking? Oh my god, is it been too long? Do I need to take it out? And these are great for overnight, because you're not like sitting in your blood, if that makes sense. But my favorite cup is this one. This one's really weird looking. Check it out. Is this kind of gross? I mean, they're all clean right now, guys. So this is the FemiCycle cup, and this is the low cervix version. I will post a picture of the three sizes they have. They have a regular, they have a teen, and they have a low cervix, which is the one I have. So the FemiCycle one was recommended to me by some of my friends, and they said they like live the FemiCycle life. They don't know how anyone lives without it type of thing. This is a $60, almost $60 cup, but this thing does not leak on me. So other cups, sometimes when they get fuller, they start to leak because of the weight, and then things get squished, and then a little bit like starts to, like spotting leaks out, not like whoosh leakage. But for me, I realized for my needs, I needed this for longer hours. Like I could empty this every like 10 hours and be good, because it has this little mechanism like this. So this flops in and out. It's like a little lip. It's like a catch. So when you fill up this cup, so as you fill the cup and the catch is down, as you turn it, it catches. Is that cool? So like if you're upside down, it doesn't like get every, that sounds weird. But you get what I'm saying. It has more of a catch, and then as you like pull it out, things don't leak out as easily. And for me, no matter how much is in there, this doesn't leak. It's very tried and true and trusted, so I love it a lot. It looks so wide compared to other things, but unlike other cups like this that need to open up fully after insertion, this does not. This can work if it's bent. Like it can be smushed like this completely and it will work. And it's very, very soft and like pliable. And this one doesn't have to fully extend. And this sits at the bottom, like basically towards the outside compared to everything else that needs to go higher. This sits at the very bottom and just catches everything. Kind of acts like a bowl compared to everything else that sits a little higher in the canal, more in the tunnel compared to the exit. So this is my tried and true. It is my BFF, and we're gonna be hanging out a lot in like 3 more days according to my Clue app, which I'm dreading. Cause now, usually like within a week before my period, I get so cranky and I have an attitude today. I honestly do, and like less positive than usual. And the cramps are gonna start, and the boobs are gonna get tender, and my face doesn't look as good as it usually does. Like I put on like my favorite foundation, and of course it doesn't look as good today because my skin is just like drier today. It's just acting up. I don't know what's going on. I didn't do anything differently to it. It's just that time of the month. So I hope you guys enjoyed hearing and seeing a little bit about my period cups. There's just so much information. These videos can get super, super long, but I wanted to kind of just share what my favorites were. I got my FemiCycle cup on Amazon Prime. And there's a lot of cups on Amazon as well as other stores and of course the company websites, and I will leave information down below. If you want to check out the Clue app, it again is free and the link will be at the top of the box. And if you enjoy just generally casually talking about sensitive subjects like this, because I think if anything, like, it should be so normalized by now, because how long have people have had periods? Like, since the dawn of time at this point. I had fun talking to you guys about it. I had fun sharing with you guys things that are kind of like taboo-ish. Oh, also pick up some Always Wipes, because those things are beasts during your time of the month. Beasts. And hang in there, girls. It's really tough being a girl. It really is. So if you enjoyed this video, enjoyed the topic, or just enjoyed generally learning a little bit more, not everything, but a little bit more about menstrual cups and kind of like normalize the fact that it's okay if you want to try these out. I also suggest when you first insert them to like have them wet, because when I tried to put the Diva cup in dry, accidents had happened and it hurt. Things rubbed incorrectly and maybe micro tears have happened. Just saying. But when there's water, you rinse them in the sink beforehand. Good for me. And other people, you know, obviously use some like lubricants of some sort if needed, I've heard on forums, but I just use water. That's me. Because I think generally it's a scary thing. There's no way you're gonna have natural like moisture when you're freaking out trying out a cup. Trust me, I don't think it happens very often. So anywho, I'm gonna stop talking. I talk a lot. And I hope you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in a later video.